Welcome to day three. And today we're going to be working on your hands. Your hands can carry a lot of different emotions. So I'm going to be showing you a chart that can help us release different emotions that may be trapped in your body, because each finger is linked to a meridian, which is linked to an organ, which carries certain emotions. So we're going to help you release that and do it really, really simply. So let's get right to it. So what I want you to do is we're just going to start with rubbing our hands together. So as you can see in this chart above me, the palms of the hands are about nourishing. Okay, so this is an old Japanese practice that allows you to connect and create and release some emotions. And so the hands are actually really about connecting to the universe and connecting you, because we use them to bring things to us and push things away. So our hands are extremely valuable, especially with homunculus. Your brain thinks your hands are huge. So right now, the nourish is what we're trying to do. So what I want to do is just focus on, do a deep inhale through the nose and exhale. And so you can go clockwise or counterclockwise, however you want to stimulate that. That's really up to you. And we're going to do one more breath. Go ahead and inhale and exhale. Okay, great. Now, if you pull your hands apart, you can just feel that energy. Now you can feel that connection. It's like, oh yeah, feel that. How far apart can you go? Feel that energy that you're creating. So we are energy. So today we're all going to be, it's about creating the energy of joy and releasing that out of our bodies. So it's been hiding inside of us. Okay, so now let's check on the different meridians. So what I want you to do to start is I just want you to grab the end of your thumb, and I want you just to roll it and go to each finger and just roll and just notice what it feels like. Can it roll easily? Can it rotate? Can it twist? And notice which finger doesn't twist as much. So for me, definitely the pinky and this ring finger. Okay, what we're gonna do is each finger. So how this practice works, it's really, really simple, is that you're actually gonna grab your whole appendage, your whole thumb for, in this instance. And what I want you to do is I want you just to, you can just hold it if you'd like and pull gently, okay? So you're gonna grab it and pull up, or you can twist left or right if it is tight, okay? So it's really up to you, but we're just gonna hold some tension and we're gonna do two breaths per spot, okay? So I'm just, basically what we're doing is that we're just gonna hold some connection. So we're gonna use the heat that we created in the opposite hand, and we're just gonna hold and twist if you have any restrictions, okay? So I'm gonna start on my hand that I do have a restriction. My pinky, so I'm gonna start on my pinky. I'm gonna start on my right hand because I'm holding more restrictions. So again, just like your feet, your hands, the right hand has to do with more masculine, focusing on the future. Your left hand has to be more with the feminine. So my left hand seems to be doing well. Today, I'm a little bit more restricted on my right hand. So I'm going to start there. So you start on whatever hand you want, okay? So what we're going to do is I'm going to start with my pinky. My pinky is all about having self-doubt. It's linked to the heart and small intestine meridian. So what we're going to do is that if you do have a restriction like me, then I want you to twist it in whatever direction there is a restriction. So mine's this way. And then you're just going to hold on. If you don't have a restriction, I just want you to hold and pull. Okay. And we're going to do two breaths. Ready? Go ahead and inhale. So if you do have a restriction, you'll notice that that restriction tends to let go after two breaths. So let's continue on. So ring finger is all about sadness. So this is linked to the lungs and the large intestine. So again, if you want to twist either way, when you twist, you can feel the opening and you can feel the myofascial release. If you just want to hold it, you can do that too. So go ahead and let's release some sadness in your, that may be stuck in your body. Go ahead, inhale. Let's go middle finger. So again, I had a restriction here, so I'm going to twist. Middle finger has to do with anger, and this is linked to your liver and gallbladder. Right away, I feel like it opens up as soon as I exhale. So you can be breathing in through the nose and out through the nose if you want, or out through the mouth. Okay, beautiful. Let's move on to the next finger. So your index finger, and this has to do with fear, linked to the kidney and bladder meridian, which we talked about yesterday. Time for your thumb. Worry is where we tend to hold thumb, in your thumb. And so this is the spleen and the stomach meridian. Breathe in. I'm already feeling like so much more relief on that right side. All right, so let's go through the left side for, or let's switch hands. So I'm gonna start the pinky. Given that, you can feel the heat and the restrictions just let go. It's beautiful, I love it. Next finger, sadness. Is there sadness linked to your for me on my left hand, to my feminine energy? Nope, does feels pretty good. Next one is anger. Good breath on that one for me. Fantastic. Fear. And finally, worry on the feminine side for me. Well done. All right, so let's rub our hands together. So now we're gonna move that energy. So what I want you to do is always, we always wanna focus on the top of the hand as well. So I want you to just take your thumb and I want you to rub in between each of the metacarpals and just try to create some space, however you like to do that. So if you have some essential oils, you could certainly rub it on the top of your hand. There's three points actually I'll mention since we're talking about the hands today. It's called Buddha's Triangle. So there's a heart meridian, a lung meridian, and a pericardium. So again, so the emotions can get stuck in those particular meridians. So what we can do is we can put essential oils there and rub that, and that can start opening and shifting the frequency of those meridians as well. So essential oils, extremely powerful. But right now, or you have, you can use your facial roller or gua sha tool. I love the gua sha tool because when you start using it and pulling it against your tissues like this, you can really feel, for me, it's like some bubble wrap, some restrictions. So I do have some scars on my hands. So there's some restrictions there. So anyway, so we want to create some space in there. Okay, good. Rub those hands together. Fantastic. Shake that off. Let's do a couple neuro exercises just to get some movement in as well. Just to, like in my world of personal training, stabilize. So cover the thumb, open it up, spread the fingers, cover the thumb. We'll do that three times. Good. And then we'll go pinky first and the thumb this way. Good job. Okay. And then if you can, just pull the tissues on the back of the hand like this and then try to close your fist and then open that up. That's a nice, you can feel a nice squeeze on that one. That's great to open up that fascia on the back of the hand. So we use our hands all the time. It's all about connection. So we can move the tissues and get some fluidity back in the hands there. So my favorite one, thumb up, pinky out. Ready? We're gonna switch it. One, two, three, switch. One, two, three, switch. One, two, three, switch. One, two, three, switch. Okay, awesome. Well done, well done, well done. That is your movement snack for today. Now, let's get dancing. Till the day when you knock on my door. Well done, my friends. Happy day 3. I will see you tomorrow for day 4. Have a beautiful day.